obligation, nothing is holy. Bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that we, with you as our ruler and God, may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
and saw a large crowd was coming to him. He said to Philip, "Where can we buy enough food for them to eat?" He said this to test him, because he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 200 days' wages worth of food would not be enough for each of them to have a little." One of his disciples, Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what good are they for so many?" Jesus said, "Have the people recline." And there was a great deal of grass in that place. So the men reclined, about 5,000 in number. And Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks, and distributed them to those who were reclining, and also as much of the fish as they wanted. They had their bid. He said to his disciples, "Gather the fragments left over, so that nothing will be wasted." So they collected them and filled 12 wicker baskets with fragments and the 5 barley loaves and more than they could. The people saw the sign he had done. They said, "This is truly the prophet, one who has come into the world." So Jesus knew they were going to come and carry him off to make him king. He withdrew again to the mountain below. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We can listen. listen to it, we can hear it and say, okay, miracle Jesus. And the people, they went on. And fast forward some 2,000 years later, today, we can be stuck in that. We say, yeah, here I am. Doing my duty. Going to church. Getting Christ. The message is far greater. And it's really one word. It's one word. Never enough. We see Jesus feeding the hungry. And they're worried. And they're anxious. Are we going to have enough? Somehow this is not enough. And that we're looking and we're searching and we're trying to find more and more. And in that searching and that looking and coming up and we make these shores, we hunger and we thirst. Or we'll take in all this other stuff that we think is going to feed us, that we think is going to sustain us. But it comes and it goes back and forth and forth and back. Struggling every day. It's not enough. It's not enough. We get frustrated. We can start complaining. Self-pity. Doubt. Just all the things that flow. Just imagine if we could live the message the reality the one word enough. Even know how to live. And breathe. And move. Because gives us far more. How do we see that? How do we understand that? And how do we live that? God our God. And God gave us everything, and it's only God and His Son. Shed His blood, His body for us. It would be far more than we know. So receive. Receive what God is speaking. Oh. Are you being fed? Are you being fed? Or is it just another story? Just another reality? Just something that sounds nice and good and wonderful on earth. His purpose. His mission. His intent. Because my dear friend, as they close tonight, we have the greatest gift ever. Because we are not the lies. We are not the trash. We are not the scraps. We are fed with the body, with the blood of Jesus Christ. And as far enough in the most holy Eucharist, which we will have the privilege to partake of. Ever.
by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and he became man. For our Savior to survive under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will not have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds with the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess on baptism the forgiveness of sins, and look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Trust me. God's providence, in his mercy, in his divine love, now turn our prayers and petitions for the bearer of the prayers.
For Pope Francis and all church leaders that they work for and call for the good of all, we pray to you.
Good and gracious God, how blessed we are to be in this beautiful church, coming hungry and thirsty, living in a world where nothing is ever enough. You stop us, and you remind us of your body, your blood, your soul, and your divinity is far more than enough, and even way more than you ever need. We make all of these prayers in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
through the power of working with your grace. These most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal godliness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you so love the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin. You might love in us what you love in your Son, by whose obedience we have restored to the gifts of yours, and by sinning they had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them in to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, your spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you for your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
yourself gave us. Love is on all gentlemen. May profit us our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And